This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A planned or constructed language, sometimes called a conlang, is a language whose phonology, grammar, and vocabulary have been consciously devised for human or human-like communication, instead of having developed naturally. It is also referred to as an artificial or invented language. There are many possible reasons to create a constructed language, such as, to ease human communication, see International Auxiliary Language and Code, to give fiction or an associated constructed setting an added layer of realism, for experimentation in the fields of linguistics, cognitive science, and machine learning, for artistic creation, and for language games. The expression planned language is sometimes used to mean international auxiliary languages and other languages designed for actual use in human communication. Some prefer it to the adjective artificial, for the latter may be perceived as pejorative outside Esperanto culture. The term language planning means the prescriptions given to a natural language to standardize it. In this regard, even natural languages may be artificial in some respects. Prescriptive grammars, which date to ancient times for classical languages such as Latin and Sanskrit, are rule-based codifications of natural languages, such codifications being a middle ground between naive natural selection and development of language and its explicit construction. The term glossopoeia is also used to mean language construction, particularly construction of artistic languages. As a quantitative example of the use of conlangs within a country, the Hungarian census of 2001 found 4,570 speakers of Esperanto, 10 of Romanid, 2 each of Interlingua and Edo, and 1 each of Idiom Neutral and Mundolingo. The Russian census of 2010 found 992 speakers of Esperanto, 9 of Edo, 1 of Edo, and no speaker of Slovio and Interlingua. Contents: 1. Planned, constructed, artificial. 2. Overview. 3. A priori and a posteriori languages. 31. A priori language. 311. Schematic. 312. Experimental. 313. Artistic. 32. A posteriori language. 321. Controlled. 322. Naturalistic. 33. Schematic. 4. History. 41. Ancient linguistic experiments. 42. Early constructed languages. 43. Perfecting language. 44. 17th and 18th century, advent of philosophical languages. 45. 19th and 20th century, auxiliary languages. 46. Artlangs. 47. Modern conlang organizations. 5. Collaborative constructed languages. 6. See also. 7. Notes. 8. References. 9. External links. Planned, constructed, artificial. The terms planned, constructed, and artificial are used differently in some traditions. For example, few speakers of Interlingua consider their language artificial, since they assert that it has no invented content. Interlingua's vocabulary is taken from a small set of natural languages, and its grammar is based closely on these source languages, even including some degree of irregularity. Its proponents prefer to describe its vocabulary and grammar as standardized rather than artificial or constructed. Similarly, Latino sign flexione LSF is a simplification of Latin from which the inflections have been removed, as with Interlingua. Some prefer to describe its development as planning rather than constructing. Some speakers of Esperanto and Esperantidos also avoid the term artificial language because they deny that there is anything unnatural about the use of their language in human communication. By contrast, some philosophers have argued that all human languages are conventional or artificial. François Rabelais, for instance, stated, "C'est abus de dire que nous avons une langue naturelle, les langues sont par institution arbitraires et conventions des pupils." It's an abuse to say that we have a natural language. Languages are arbitrary and conventions of peoples by institution. An artificial language can also refer to a language that emerges naturally out of experimental studies within the framework of artificial language evolution. Further, fictional and experimental languages can be naturalistic in that they are meant to sound natural, have realistic amounts of irregularity, and, if derived a posteriori from a real-world natural language or a real-world reconstructed proto-language such as Vulgar Latin or Proto-Indo-European, or from a fictional proto-language, they try to imitate natural processes of phonological, lexical, and grammatical change. In contrast with Interlingua, they are not usually intended for easy learning or communication, and most artlangers do not. Consider interlingua to be naturalistic in the sense in which this term is used in artlang criticism. Thus, a naturalistic fictional language tends to be more difficult and complex, while interlingua has simpler grammar, syntax, and orthography than its source languages. Though more complex and irregular than Esperanto or its descendants, naturalistic fictional languages typically mimic behaviors of natural languages like irregular verbs and nouns and complicated phonological processes. Overview in terms of purpose, most constructed languages can broadly be divided into engineered languages engalangs, and laws, further subdivided into logical languages loglangs, philosophical languages, and experimental languages, devised for the purpose of experimentation in logic, philosophy, or linguistics, auxiliary languages oxlangs, devised for international communication, also IALs, for international auxiliary language, artistic languages artlangs, devised to create aesthetic pleasure or humorous effect, just for fun, usually secret languages, and mystical languages are classified as artlangs. The boundaries between these categories are by no means clear. A constructed language could easily fall into more than one of the above categories. A logical language created for aesthetic reasons would also be classifiable as an artistic language, which might be created by someone with philosophical motives intending for said conlang to be used as an auxiliary language. There are no rules, either inherent in the process of language construction or externally imposed, that would limit a constructed language to fitting only one of the above categories. A constructed language can have native speakers if young children learn it from parents who speak it fluently. According to Ethnologue, there are 2,000 who speak Esperanto as a first language. A member of the Klingon Language Institute, Darman Spears, attempted to raise his son as a native bilingual with English Klingon speaker. As soon as a constructed language has a community of fluent speakers, especially if it has numerous native speakers, it begins to evolve and hence loses its constructed status. For example, modern Hebrew and its pronunciation norms were developed from existing traditions of Hebrew, such as Mishnaic Hebrew and Biblical Hebrew, following a general Sephardic pronunciation, rather than engineered from scratch, and has undergone considerable changes since the State of Israel was founded in 1948. Hetzron 1990-693. However, linguist Gilad Zuckerman argues that modern Hebrew, which he terms Israeli, is a Semito-European hybrid based not only on Hebrew but also on Yiddish and other languages spoken by revivalist. Zuckerman therefore endorses the translation of the Hebrew Bible into what he calls Israeli. Esperanto as a living spoken language has evolved significantly from the prescriptive blueprint published in 1887, so that modern editions of the Fundamenta Crestomatio, a 1903 collection of early texts in the language, require many footnotes on the syntactic and lexical differences between early and modern Esperanto. Proponents of constructed languages often have many reasons for using them. The famous but disputed Sapir-Whorf hypothesis is sometimes cited. This claims that the language one speaks influences the way one thinks. Thus, a better language should allow the speaker to think more clearly or intelligently, or to encompass more points of view. This was the intention of Suzette Hayden Elgin in creating Layden, a feminist language embodied in her feminist science fiction series Native Tongue. A constructed language could also be used to restrict thought, as in George Orwell's Newspeak, or to simplify thought, as in Toki Pona. In contrast, linguists such as Steven Pinker argue that ideas exist independently of language. For example, in the book The Language Instinct, Pinker states that children spontaneously reinvent slang and even grammar with each generation. These linguists argue that attempts to control the range of human thought through the reform of language would fail, as concepts like freedom will reappear in new words if the old words vanish. Proponents claim a particular language makes it easier to express and understand concepts in one area, and more difficult in others. An example can be taken from the way various programming languages make it easier to write certain kinds of programs and harder to write others. Another reason cited for using a constructed language is the telescope rule, which claims that it takes less time to first learn a simple constructed language and then a natural language, than to learn only a natural language. Thus, if someone wants to learn English, some suggest learning basic English first. Constructed languages like Esperanto and interlingua are in fact often simpler due to the typical lack of irregular verbs and other grammatical quirks. Some studies have found that learning Esperanto helps in learning a non-constructed language later. See propaedeutic value value of Esperanto codes for constructed languages include the ISO 639-2 ART for conlangs. However, some constructed languages have their own ISO 639 language codes, e.g. EO and EPO for Esperanto, JBO for Lojban, IA and INA for Interlingua, TLH for Klingon and IO and EDO for EDO a priori and a posteriori languages. And a priori constructed language is one whose features, including vocabulary, grammar, etc., are not based on an existing language, and an a posteriori language is the opposite. This categorization, however, is not absolute, as many constructed languages may be both a priori and a posteriori depending on which linguistic factors of them are observed. A priori language and a priori language from Latin a priori, from the former, is any constructed language of which all or a number of features are not based on existing languages, but rather invented or elaborated as to work in a different way or to elude different purposes. Some a priori languages are designed to be international auxiliary languages that remove what could be considered an unfair learning advantage for native speakers of a source language that would otherwise exist for a posteriori languages. Other, known as philosophical or taxonomic languages, try to categorize their vocabulary, either to express an underlying philosophy or to make it easier to recognize new vocabulary schematic. Schematic constructed languages, of which most are designed to be international auxiliary, are those with a usual distinctive feature compared to naturalistic languages, those largely imitating natural languages, a more regular and precise grammatical system to avoid ambiguities and difficulty in studying and understanding them. In the other hand, their vocabulary is almost always a posteriori, which makes them only half a priori. Well-known examples include Esperanto, Lojban, Lingua de Planeta, and Glossa Experimental. There have been many languages constructed to test linguistic hypotheses such as the Sapir-Whorf hypothesis and or to explore innovative or invented linguistic features. They are therefore necessarily designed with a priori features. Examples include Ithkal, Katava, Lojban and its predecessor Loglan, both of which are also schematic, and even the fictional setting. Laden artistic. Most artistic languages, i.e. those created for amusement or to serve as natural languages of fictional worlds, are largely a priori in both vocabulary and grammar. Among classical fictional natural languages are Klingon from the science fiction franchise Star Trek and the languages created by fantasy writer J.R.R. Tolkien. Other examples include Dothraki and Valyrian from Game of Thrones, Atlantean from Atlantis, The Lost Empire, Kellan by Sylvia Sotomayor and Aoi by W. John Weilgart. Laden is both experimental and artistic. A posteriori language and a posteriori language from Latin a posteriori, from the later, according to Louis Couturat, is any constructed language whose elements are borrowed from or based on existing languages. The term can also be extended to controlled versions of existing languages, and is most commonly used to refer to vocabulary despite other features in distinguishing whether the language is a priori or a posteriori. The prevalence and distribution of respectable traits is often the key. They may be controlled, naturalistic or schematic controlled. A controlled language is a version of a natural language with improvements to make it easier to learn and to use, such as reduced vocabulary, simplified grammar, etc. These include Latino sign flexione controlled versions of English, Basic English, Special English, Globish. Naturalistic. Naturalistic languages are constructed languages which largely imitate the grammar and vocabulary of a particular group of related languages within a family, thus being potentially zonal, i.e. auxiliary between speakers of these languages. Occidental, also called interling, interlingua, interslavic, folkspråk. Schematic. A constructed language is considered schematic when it features a more original grammar, which is usually precise and regular, and a vocabulary coming from languages of different families, to make it as recognizable as possible for potential international auxiliary purposes. For that they can be described as half a priori, half a posteriori. There have been many attempts of developing such a language for diverse purposes, such as Velepic Esperanto and the Esperantidos, Edo Mundolinko Loglan and Lojban. Lingua de Planeta. History. Ancient linguistic experiments. Grammatical speculation dates from classical antiquity, appearing for instance in Plato's Cratylus, in Hermogenes's contention that words are not inherently linked to what they refer to, that people apply a piece of their own voice to the thing. Athenaeus of Naucratis, in Book 3 of Dipnosophisti, tells the story of two figures, Dionysus of Sicily and Alexarchus. Dionysus of Sicily created neologisms like Menandros (virgin) from Mene (waiting) and Andra (husband), Menecrates (pillar) from Mene (it remains in one place) and Crete (it is strong) and Balanchion (javelin) from Balatianantion (thrown against someone). Incidentally, the more common Greek words for those three are Parthenos, Stoulos, and Akon. Alexarchus of Macedon, the brother of King Cassander of Macedon, was the founder of the city of Ouranopolis. Athenaeus recounts a story told by Heraclides of Lembos that Alexarchus introduced a peculiar vocabulary, referring to a rooster as a «don crier», a barber as a «mortal shaver», a drachma as «worked silver» and a herald as an «apeutes». He once wrote something to the public authorities in Cassandreas for what this letter says: in my opinion not even the Pythian god could make sense of it. While the mechanisms of grammar suggested by classical philosophers were designed to explain existing languages Latin, Greek, Sanskrit, they were not used to construct new grammars roughly contemporary to Plato. In his descriptive grammar of Sanskrit, Panini constructed a set of rules for explaining language, so that the text of his grammar may be considered a mixture of natural and constructed language. Early constructed languages, page 68R of the Voynich manuscript. This three-page foldout from the manuscript includes a chart that appears astronomical. A legend recorded in the 7th century Irish work Oricept na en Eches claims that Phanius Farsed visited Shinar after the confusion of tongues, and he and his scholars studied the various languages for 10 years, taking the best features of each to create in Berla Tobaid the selected language, which he named Goidelk, the Irish language. This appears to be the first mention of the concept of a constructed language in literature. The earliest non-natural languages were considered less constructed than supernatural, mystical, or divinely inspired. The lingua ignota, recorded in the 12th century by Saint Hildegard of Bingen, is an example, and apparently the first entirely artificial language. It is a form of private mystical cant. See also language of angels. An important example from Middle Eastern culture is Bilibalan, invented in the 16th century. Kabbalistic grammatical speculation was directed at recovering the original language spoken by Adam and Eve in Paradise. Lost in the confusion of tongues. The first Christian project for an ideal language is outlined in Dante Alighieri's De Vulgari Eloquentia, where he searches for the ideal Italian vernacular suited for literature. Ramon Lull's Ars Magna was a project of a perfect language with which the infidels could be convinced of the truth of the Christian faith. It was basically an application of combinatorics on a given set of concepts during the Renaissance. Lullian and Kabbalistic ideas were drawn upon in a magical context, resulting in cryptographic applications. The Voynich manuscript may be an example of this perfecting language. Renaissance interest in ancient Egypt, notably the discovery of the hieroglyphica of Horopoyo, and first encounters with the Chinese script directed efforts towards a perfect written language. Johannes Trithemis, in Steganographia and Polygraphia, attempted to show how all languages can be reduced to one in the 17th century. Interest in magical languages was continued by the Rosicrucians and alchemists like John Dee, and his Enochian Jakob Bahme in 1623 spoke of a natural language. Natursprache of the senses. Musical languages from the Renaissance were tied up with mysticism, magic, and alchemy, sometimes also referred to as the language of the birds. The Solezal project of 1817 reinvented the concept in a more pragmatic context. 17th and 18th century, advent of philosophical languages. The 17th century saw the rise of projects for philosophical or a priori languages, such as Francis Lodwick's A Common Writing 1647, and the groundwork or foundation laid or so intended for the framing of a new perfect language and a universal common writing 1652, Sir Thomas Urquhart's Excalibrorum 1651, and Logopandectesian 1652, George Dalgarno's Ars Signorum 1661, John Wilkins' Essay Towards a Real Character, and a philosophical language 1668. These early taxonomic conlangs produced systems of hierarchical classification that were intended to result in both spoken and written expression. Leibniz had a similar purpose for his Lingua Generalis of 1678, aiming at a lexicon of characters upon which the user might perform calculations that would yield true propositions automatically. As a side effect, developing binary calculus, these projects were not only occupied with reducing or modeling grammar, but also with the arrangement of all human knowledge into characters or hierarchies, an idea that with the Enlightenment would ultimately lead to the encyclopedia. Many of these 17th-18th centuries conlangs were pasigraphies, or purely written languages with no spoken form or a spoken form that would vary greatly according to the native language of the reader. Leibniz and the encyclopedists realized that it is impossible to organize human knowledge unequivocally in a tree diagram, and consequently to construct an a priori language based on such a classification classification of concepts under the entry character, D'Alembert critically reviewed the projects of philosophical languages of the preceding century after the Encyclopédie. Projects for a priori languages moved more and more to the lunatic fringe individual authors, typically unaware of the history of the idea, continued to propose taxonomic philosophical languages until the early 20th century, e.g. R.O., but most recent engineered languages have had more modest goals. Some are limited to a specific field, like mathematical formalism or calculus, e.g. Lingkos and programming languages. Others are designed for eliminating syntactical ambiguity, e.g. Loglan and Lojban, or maximizing conciseness, e.g. Ithkal. 19th and 20th century, auxiliary languages. Main article, international auxiliary language. Already in the Encyclopedia, attention began to focus on a posteriori auxiliary languages. Joachim Fege de Villeneuve in the article on Long wrote a short proposition of a laconic or regularized grammar of French during the 19th century. A bewildering variety of such international auxiliary languages, IALs, were proposed, so that Louis Couturat and Leopold Lowe in Histoire de la langue universelle 1903 reviewed 38 projects. The first of these that made any international impact was Volapük, proposed in 1879 by Johann Martin Schleyer. Within a decade, 283 Volapukist clubs were counted all over the globe. However, disagreements between Schleyer and some prominent users of the language led to schism, and by the mid-1890s it fell into obscurity, making way for Esperanto, proposed in 1887 by Ludwig Lejeser Zamenhof, and its descendants Interlingua, the most recent Oxlong to gain a significant number of speakers, emerged in 1951, when the International Auxiliary Language Association published its Interlingua English Dictionary and an accompanying grammar. The success of Esperanto did not stop others from trying to construct new auxiliary languages, such as Leslie Jones Urolingo, which mixes elements of English and Spanish, or He Yufuse Mondlango, which introduces more English roots instead of Latin ones. Loglan 1955 and its descendants constitute a pragmatic return to the aims of the a priori languages, tempered by the requirement of usability of an auxiliary language. Thus far, these modern a priori languages have garnered only small groups of speakers. Robot Interaction Language 2010 is a spoken language that is optimized for communication between machines and humans. The major goals of ROILA are that it should be easily learnable by the human user, and optimized for efficient recognition by computer speech recognition algorithms. Artlang's main article, Artistic Language. Artistic languages, constructed for literary enjoyment or aesthetic reasons without any claim of usefulness, begin to appear in early modern literature in Pantagruel, and in utopian contexts, but they only seem to gain notability as serious projects beginning in the 20th century. A Princess of Mars 1912 by Edgar Rice Burroughs was possibly the first fiction of that century to feature a constructed language. J.R.R. Tolkien developed a family of related fictional languages and discussed artistic languages publicly, giving a lecture entitled A Secret Vice in 1931 at a Congress. Orwell's Newspeak is considered a satire of an IAL rather than an artistic language proper. By the beginning of the first decade of the 21st century, it had become common for science fiction and fantasy works set in other worlds to feature constructed languages, or more commonly, an extremely limited but defined vocabulary which suggests the existence of a complete language, and constructed languages are a regular part of the genre, appearing in Star Wars, Star Trek, Lord of the Rings Elvish, Stargate SG-1, Atlantis, The Lost Empire, Game of Thrones. Dothraki language and Valyrian languages, Avatar, Dune and the Myst series of computer adventure games. Modern conlang organizations. Various paper zines on constructed languages were published from the 1970s through the 1990s, such as Glossopaic Quarterly, Taboo Jadu, and the Journal of Planned Languages. The conlang mailing list was founded in 1991, and later split off an auxlang mailing list dedicated to international auxiliary languages in the early to mid-1990s. Few conlang-related zines were published as email or websites, such as Vortpunoj and Model Languages. The conlang mailing list has developed a community of conlangers with its own customs, such as translation challenges and translation relays, and its own terminology. Sarah Higley reports from results of her surveys that the demographics of the conlang list are primarily men from North America and Western Europe, with a smaller number from Oceania, Asia, the Middle East, and South America, with an age range from 13 to over 60. The number of women women participating has increased over time. More recently founded online communities include the Zompist Bulletin Board ZBB, since 2001, and the Conlanger Bulletin Board. Discussion on these forums includes presentation of members' conlangs and feedback from other members, discussion of natural languages, whether particular conlang features have natural language precedents, and how interesting features of natural languages can be repurposed for conlangs, posting of interesting short texts as translation challenges, and meta-discussion about the philosophy of conlanging, conlange's purposes, and whether conlanging is an art or a hobby. Another 2001 survey by Patrick Jarrett showed an average age of 3,065, with the average time since starting to invent languages 1,183 years. A more recent thread on the ZBB showed that many conlangers spend a relatively small amount of time on any one conlang, moving from one project to another. About a third spend years on developing the same language. Collaborative constructed languages. The Tolosan language, a cultural base for the micronation known as Tolosa, was created by a single person in 1979. However, as interest in Tolosan grew, guidance of the language became in 1983 the province of a recommending body, the Comité per l'Azil del Glay, and other independent organizations of enthusiasts. Vilnian draws on Latin, Greek, and the Scandinavian languages in its syntax and grammar. It is reminiscent of Chinese. The core elements were created by a single person, and its vocabulary is now enlarged by suggestions from the internet community. While most constructed languages begin as did Tolosan, having been created by a single person, a few are created by group collaborations. Examples of these are Interlingua, which was developed by the International Auxiliary Language Association, and Lojban, which was developed by a breakaway group of Loglanists. Group collaboration has apparently become more common in recent years, as constructed language designers have started using internet tools to coordinate design efforts. NGL, Toxer was an early internet collaborative engineered language whose designers used a mailing list to discuss and vote on grammatical and lexical design issues. More recently, the Demos IAL project was developing an international auxiliary language with similar collaborative methods. The Voxhigid and Novial 98 languages were both worked on by mailing lists, though neither was issued in final form. Several artistic languages have been developed on different constructed language wikis, usually involving discussion and voting on phonology, grammatical rules, and so forth. An interesting variation is the corpus approach, exemplified by Module and Calusa mid 2006, where contributors simply read the corpus of existing sentences and add their own sentences, perhaps reinforcing existing trends or adding new words and structures. The Calusa engine adds the ability for visitors to rate sentences acceptable or unacceptable. There is no explicit statement of grammatical rules or explicit definition of words in this corpus approach. The meaning of words is inferred from their use in various sentences of the corpus, perhaps in different ways by different readers and contributors, and the grammatical rules can be inferred from the structures of the sentences that have been rated highest by the contributors and other visitors. See also constructed languages portal. List of constructed languages. Aboriginal constructed languages, Daman, Eskayan, Idioglossia, ISO, SIL, and BCP. Language codes for constructed languages. Language construction. Artificial script. Langmaker. Language construction kit. Language game. Language regulator. List of language inventors. Language modeling and translation. Knowledge representation. Language translation. Metalanguage. Universal grammar. Mystical languages. Glossolalia. Language of the birds. Spontaneous emergence of grammar. Artificial language. June and Jennifer Gibbons. Nicaraguan sign language. Origin of language. Pidgin. Poto and Cabengo. Linguistic determinism. Linguistic relativity. Pisigraphy. Universal language. Basic English notes. Carrot. Adrian Morgan. Conlanging and phonetics. The outer horde. The colors represent creative energy, and the layers of the tower imply that a conlang is built piece by piece, never completed. The tower itself also alludes to the Tower of Babel, as it has long been a tradition to demonstrate a constructed language by translating the Babel legend. The conlang flag was decided on by a vote between many competing designs, and one of my own contributions to the conlanging world is that I was the person who facilitated this election. The winning design was drawn by Christian Thalman, who introduced the layers. The idea of including the Tower of Babel on the flag had been introduced by Jan van Steenbergen, and the idea of placing the sun on the horizon behind it by Leland Paul. The idea of having the rising sun on the flag had been introduced by David Peterson, who saw it as representing the rise of conlanging from obscurity to popularity and notoriety. Carrot, Ishtar for Belgium to Belgrade. European Broadcasting Union retrieved 19 May 2013. 1973, cited in Claude Piron, Le défi des langues l'armaton, 1994, ISBN 2-7384-2432-5 re, naturalistic for Oxlangers vs. Artlangers. A UXLANG mailing list post by Jorg Riemeyer, 30 August 2009 The Conlang Triangle by Raymond Brown accessed 8 August 2008 Gavin Edwards, Babel Unrevisited, Wired Magazine, issue 708, August 1999 Hybridity vs. Revivability, Multiple Causation, Forms and Patterns, Gilad Zuckerman, Journal of Language Contact, Varia 2, pp 40-67-2009 Let My People Know, Gilad Zuckerman, Jerusalem Post, May 18, 2009 Fundamenta Crestomatio, ed. L. Zamenhof, 1903, 18th edition with footnotes by Gaston Waringian, UEA 1992 ABC Joshua Foer, John Quijada and Ithkel, The Language He Invented, The New Yorker, December 24, 2012 My hypothesis was that if I constructed a language designed specifically to provide a more adequate mechanism for expressing women's perceptions, women would have embrace it and begin using it, or B. embrace the idea but not the language, say, Elgin. You've got it all wrong, and construct some other women's language to replace it. Glatzer, Jenna 2007 interview with Suzette Hayden Elgin archived from the original on 12 June 2007 retrieved 20 March 2007. More persistently than the ZBB thread carrot NGL Central Repository GeoCityescom archived from the original on 27 October 2009. P. Definitions from Wiktionary Media from Commons News from Wikinews Textbooks from Wikibooks Data from Wikidata Constructed Language at DEMOS Conlang Atlas of Language Structures, a typological database of conlangs, based on the World Atlas of Language Structures Blueprints for Babel, focusing on international auxiliary languages Garrett's links to Logical Languages Department of Planned Languages Esperanto Museum of the Austrian National Library The Conlangers Library Henrik Thaling's Conlanguage Resources Jorg Riemeyer's Conlang page VE Constructed Languages Concepts. Constructed Script Fictional Language Language Game Musical Language Relexification Universal Language Zonal Language Philosophical Language Experimental Language A Priori Language A Posteriori Language Oligosynthetic Language International Auxiliary Languages IALs Afrihili BABM Blissymbols Bolak Esperanto Folksprache Glossa Idiom Neutral Ido Interlingua International Sign Interslavic Long Nouvelle Lingua Franca Nova Lingua de Planeta Mundolinko Nal Bino Neo Novial Occidental Sambasa Slovio. Solezal Sona Spokal Europi Volepic Engineered Languages Aui Ithkel Kalaba X Loglan and Lojban Ro Toki Pona Fictional Setting and Other Artistic Languages Atlantean Brythonic Dothraki and Valyrian. Enchanta Kellen Klingon Kobayan Laden Middle Earth Languages Quenya Sundaran Moor Navi Nadsat Tionit Saliani Verdorian Wenedic Ritual and Other Languages Balibalan Daman. Enochian Eskayan Linkos Lingua Ignata Metafadran and Co. Yurkish Portal List of Constructed Languages List of Language Creators Authority Control NDL 00574782